Hi guys, my name is Matti Sulanto and I'm a photographer. Welcome to another video from Melbourne, Australia. In this video I have with me the Laowa 10mm f2.8 super ultra-wide full-frame autofocus lens. And in this video I'm going to share my user experience with this lens mounted on the Sony A7 Mark IV camera body. This is not going to be extreme pixel peeping, but of course if I see some weird optical behavior or unsharpness where unsharpness should not be or something similar, I will report that. Of course, this is the very first autofocus Laowa lens, and correct me if I'm wrong, but I think Laowa is the last of the mainstream Chinese manufacturers to go autofocus, and I think that's great. I think most of us consumers will want autofocus rather than manual focus. This lens is available for the Sony E mount and for the Nikon Z mount as an autofocus lens. There is also a version for the Canon RF mount and for the L mount, but those two versions are manual focus. To keep things interesting, there will also be two different aperture mechanisms available. The standard version, like this one, has 5 aperture blades for those good-looking sun stars. But according to Laowa, in the future, there will also be a 14-blade aperture available for maybe better looking bokeh, I don't know. But that 14-blade version will always be manual focus, regardless of the mount. This lens looks quite unique, and it's the massive focus ring that catches your attention first. And I think it's interesting that they decided to make the ring so massive looking, because you're not likely to use it that much. This is an autofocus lens after all. There is a manual focus autofocus switch here on the side of the lens, but no other features or buttons or anything like that. In the messages Laowa sent to me, they did not mention anything about weather sealing, but I can see that there is a rubber seal around the mount, so I guess this lens has some sort of weather sealing too. In real life, this lens is not as heavy as it looks. This weighs in at about 420 grams and the filter size is 77 millimeters. However, the large diameter lens barrel leaves very little room between the camera grip and the lens. And if I was wearing gloves, for example, I could not get a proper grip of my camera. Of course, with another camera body, the situation might be different, but at least with the Sony A7 Mark IV, there is very little room between the lens and the camera body. There's plenty of perspective distortion, but that's what you get with any super ultra-wide rectilinear design. And that's part of the appeal too. That's what creates that dramatic perspective to your pictures. There are some apps like DxO Viewpoint, by the way, which I have reviewed. I'll put the link up here just in case you are interested. That app can sort of squeeze in the picture and remove some of the part of the perspective distortion, but at the same time you'll destroy the dramatic feel. And my advice simply is that if you don't like the strong perspective distortion, get another lens with a narrower angle of view and be happy. Laowa claims this lens has almost zero geometrical distortion, and that is true. There is only a mild barrel distortion visible if your picture has straight lines near the edges of the frame. It's nothing to worry about and not too distracting, and very easy to remove if it is distracting. I think Laowa has done a really, really super nice job correcting the distortions. And there are so many other lenses that are not nearly as wide as this that suffer from much more severe distortions. This 5 aperture blade version makes really good looking Sunstar as expected with 5 aperture blades. Also the backlight performance is really good in my opinion for such an ultra wide lens. I can't see any bad reflections or bad flare in any of my pictures. But of course you can make any lens flare if you really really try. I've been shooting some street photos here in Melbourne CBD on this Laowa 10mm lens, and I'm having a good fun, but also the ultra-wide nature of this lens makes traditional street photography a bit of a challenge. I'm pretty confident when I'm doing street photography. I have no problem pointing my camera at people, but I also don't want to do any Bruce Gilden stunts. I don't want to push my camera into anyone's face. But with this lens, if you want anything that is even remotely like a close-up, you have to be so close. I mean, I'm talking about less than 1 meter distance, and to me, that's starting to be intrusive, and I'm not very confident or happy doing things like that with my camera. So with this lens, I have to take a different approach and choose some wider scenes. And I think that works as long as I have something or enough elements to fill up the whole frame. With the ultra wide like this, I think the worst problem is, or the most challenging problem, if you can call it a problem, is to sort of fill the whole frame with something that has some significance in the picture, or something that works for the composition in the picture. It's very easy to leave a lot of negative space, a lot of emptiness, especially in the foreground, and that doesn't always work for the composition. Based on my experience so far, this lens is very sharp. I have nothing to complain about the sharpness of my pictures. I'm very, very happy. But of course, a super ultra-wide lens like this is never gonna be comparable to something like a 50mm lens when it comes to corner-to-corner sharpness. This ultra-wide angle just has its limitations that we have to accept. And the same applies to vignetting. Ultra-wide lenses always have quite a lot of vignetting, and it's just part of the design, and there's no way around it except correcting it in post or in camera. The autofocus is fast, silent, and reliable based on my experience so far. The minimum focusing distance is only 0.12 meters from the sensor and only a couple of centimeters from the front element. And when you combine that with this super extreme wide angle, you can create some pretty interesting close-ups. The this kind of a super ultra-wide lens is not an easy lens to master because there is so much going on in the frame. It takes some practice to notice everything, and especially the things that are happening towards the extreme corners and edges of the frame are so easy to neglect. One thing I keep wondering is why Lauowa decided to make this specific lens their first autofocus lens. Maybe they wanted to have the widest autofocus prime lens in their lineup. I don't know. But with a 10mm super ultra-wide lens, autofocus is not necessary. It's convenient, but it's not necessary the same way it would be necessary with maybe a 50mm f1.2 lens, which would be much more difficult to focus manually, accurately and quickly. This lens has so much depth of field, even wide open at f2.8, that it would be relatively easy to zone focus almost in every situation. I really hope that in the future, Lauowa will make autofocus versions of some of their other lenses too. They have some longer focal length, fast aperture primes that would be really awesome if they had autofocus. The price for this lens is $799 US, and as far as I understand, the price is the same for every version, regardless of the number of the aperture plates or regardless of the focusing system, whether it's autofocus or manual focus. This kind of a super ultra-wide lens is always a special purpose lens. Lauowa says this is good for astrophotography or panoramic type of shots. This could also be used for interiors or pretty much anything, and I guess some especially younger photographers who seem to be more into wide-angle photography, they might get the kick out of this lens. And why not? This is a lot of fun. But also, if you use this lens a lot, the effect can wear out pretty quickly. This is all I have for you in this video. If you found this useful or helpful, please do consider buying me a cup of coffee. There's a link down below for that if you don't live in Finland. Thanks so much, and I'll definitely see you soon in the next one.